Gentle Radio with your host, Genty.
It must be the ass.
Yeah, fucking Jen is a warlord.
Anyone who's going through this, okay, everybody's going through this right now. Take a breath, deep breath. Look up, be thankful for your life, be thankful they gave you another fucking day, and mind your business. Don't go out. There's nobody you need to know. No, I don't need to know nothing. If you need coffee from Starbucks, hang yourself now. Stop it. You don't need no fucking coffee from Starbucks. You're going out for the essentials, okay? You're not going out for... Don't go to fucking a big supermarket. Do not go to a big supermarket. You cannot be this dumb. And if you go shopping, it's at 8:01, at 7:01. Go to those side little supermarkets, like a little Hindu market. They got fucking the essentials in there. You know what I'm saying? They got curry, which you're not going to buy, and hummus, which you're not going to buy. But they got milk. They got bread. They got eggs. They love eggs. The Hindus love eggs. If anybody's got an egg right now, it's the fucking Hindus, okay? And I love them. I ain't mad at nobody. I'm just telling you the truth. Do not go to those big chains. Please, do it for your Uncle Joey. You know where the little ones are. You drive by them every day. They got the essentials. Ground beef is ground beef. Just don't buy it at the back market, all right? Don't buy it at the back market. Ground beef is ground beef. So you can still make your fucking meatballs. You can still make your spaghetti sauce. You can still do whatever. Listen, for these next 2 weeks, I'm trying with all my heart not to get a fuck. You know, I've been dying without my fucking burrito, my bean and beef, my bean and cheese burrito.
Really? You like that much?
I love it. I love beans.
Okay.
But I can't go there because there's no social distancing.
Right.
And there's people sitting and eating there. So that scares the shit out of me. I want to support local people. You know, I want to support local people. Once you told me you weren't eating out no more.
No, you can't.
If you're not eating out, then I'm not eating out. So I'm trying to support the places. Like, I've been craving fucking sushi.
Oh, me too.
Yeah. I've been craving sushi more than all you motherfuckers. But do I go? No. So I don't want to fucking hear nobody fucking crying. We're going to deal with the guidelines. We're going to do what the fuck they tell us to do. And that's it. And this all fucking pass. I get to live. You get to live. Your parents get to live. Your grandparents get to live. This is a happy ending. If you don't fucking stay home, it's only going to get worse.
Welcome to Ramble for Radio. I am your host, Gen T. Twitter and Instagram at GenT523. What's going on, motherfuckers? I am exhausted. Let me just give you a little idea of how exhausted I am, emotionally and physically exhausted from people and their fucking demands. I have managed to fall asleep sitting up the last 3 nights in a row. And particularly those 3 nights start in the bathtub. So your dear host Rambo almost drowned because I just fucking fell asleep in the bathtub sitting up, because the bathtub I have sadly was built in the 80s, and I guess everybody in the 80s was 5'3". I'm 5'8", so I can't lay back in the tub. I have to sit upright, so which is fine because I'm just trying to soak my leg and get rid of this goddamn hematoma I got in my leg. It's been like 36 days with this shit. I'm fucking over it. So whatever, I just sit in there and soak in Epsom salt and pray that it goes away so I can exercise, because I'm going out of my fucking mind. So I've just been sitting in the tub the last 3 nights and falling asleep. That's how tired I am. Upright. Sitting in the tub, falling asleep, just complete crazy. But I played that clip for you from the Uncle Joey Diaz podcast because he's right, goddammit. He's so right. You motherfuckers don't need shit. Stay the fuck home. And if you have to go out, go get your ass up out of bed 7-8 o'clock in the morning. You ain't hanging out at the store for hours. You get your ass up, you get what you need, and you get the fuck right back home. You go to the little Hindu mart with the eggs. Oh, I love Uncle Joe. He's the best. But he's serious. This is just the best advice. Just do what they say. Stop trying to go out, trying to hang out, do all this crazy shit. Stay the fuck home. Do what they say. Whoever they is. Today it's they is me, so I'm telling you, stay the fuck home unless you absolutely need anything. Essentials, stay the fuck home. Don't go out. Get shit delivered if you have to have something. Get it delivered if you can. If you don't want it delivered, fine, but go early. Get your shit, get the fuck back home. make it easy for us essential workers so we can travel safely on the road away from all you weirdos. I think it was Monday or Tuesday. I witnessed five car accidents between a 25-minute drive from my work to home. So please, please don't go out unless you absolutely fucking have to. And as of today, which this was made public 2-3 days ago, it is official. If you leave your house, you have to wear a mask. You have to wear a mask. Your dear host Ram Boper does not like this, but that is what I have to do. And if I'm doing it, so can you. So please, for the love of God, put the damn mask on. Can't find a mask, get a scarf, get a shirt, tie it over your fucking head. Not while you're driving, but while you're out of your car, away from your home. Put that shit on. Please don't be like the dickheads that shop at my work and try and fight me. Fight! You want to have a verbal altercation about a mask that the county ordinance is asking you to uphold. Not me, not the company I work for, the county that you live in, bitch. We're just going to go right into it. Customers of the week. So Tuesday, I think it was mandatory, Tuesday. And so around 3-4 o'clock, it was mandatory. So we started telling everybody, hey, we're letting you in now, but don't come back tomorrow and think you're going to come in without a mask. You got to wear a mask, okay? We're being cool today, okay? People were complete dicks, still are dicks. And one lady was like, it's not federal. The fuck, bitch? What do you mean it's not federal? The county is independent of the federal, you jackass. You live in the county of San Bernardino. Put your goddamn mask on or take your ass back home. You ain't coming in here without a mask.
Well, it's not federal. It's not federally mandatory.
Well, are you retarded?
The public health department of the San Bernardino County is saying you gotta wear a fucking mask. If you leave your house, that means you gotta wear a fucking mask, bitch. And if you ain't got one, you ain't coming in here. Because my work could get in trouble. It's a violation. We don't want violations. We don't want to get shut down. So she was insisting, and I said, ma'am, if you do not, go and put a mask on, a shirt, a hoodie, a jacket, something to cover your face so we only see your eyes. A fucking hijab, a burqa, I don't give a fuck. If you don't leave, I'm gonna call the police. She was like, fine. Next morning, this bitch comes back with a mask. Shocker. Yeah, because you want to come in here and hang out, which she did. She shopped for 2 hours. She only bought 3 things, but she talked to her friend for 2 hours. 2 fucking hours at my work. We might as well put a shirt on the bitch, for crying out loud. 2 hours she was at my work. She just wanted to hang out. So then another gentleman rolls up and said, sir, gotta have a mask on. Can't come in here without a mask.
I don't wanna wear a mask.
Oh, well, neither do I. But you have to wear one in order to shop in here. If you don't have one, you can't come in.
Oh, I don't wanna wear one. Where are we supposed to get one?
Walks out to his car. Lo and behold, ta-da, has a mask. I mean, this is just crazy. You want to have a fight with somebody at a grocery store about the rules, but you got a mask. Okay, just so we're clear. Another lady comes in and said, ma'am, can't come in without a mask.
Well, I'm just buying 2 things.
No, ma'am. It doesn't matter if you're buying 10 things. You can't come in here without a mask. This is a county ordinance. Okay.
Well, you guys should provide us with them if that's a requirement.
Provide you. Think of how stupid that sentence sounds. The county
said that if you leave your house, ma'am, you need to provide yourself with a fucking mask. Whether you go and buy one, I know there's a mask shortage right now, so whether you make one, whether you take a washcloth and put a rubber band on the two sides and tie it to your fucking head, I don't give a fuck, but you can't come in here and buy two things. Oh my God. Oh my God. Do you have to be a complete? Do you have to be a complete jackass? Stop it. Oh my gosh. I mean, I said, ma'am, okay. Do you have a shirt? Do you have something to tie across your face? Anything. Cover your face. So she unzips her hoodie and like holds the hoodie over her face with her hand. Fine. But then she's like taking it off to look at stuff. And I said, ma'am, I can't have you take it off. It has to stay on if you're in this building. Well, I don't know. Oh God. I said, if you can't do this, you have to leave. So she got all upset, left, came back with a mask, put it on, came in. And then when she was leaving, I said, have a nice day. And she just stared at me. She tried to mad dog me. I was like, huh? I was like, girl, sweets, you're lucky. You're lucky, my boss. The owner's son is looking right at me, because I swear to God, I'll tell you some shit right now. But I just said, bye-bye. I pulled out the OG Fajardo. I pulled out the Oscar. I was like, okay, bye-bye now. Oh my God. It's just too much. I don't understand it. Listen, I don't want to participate. And guess where I stayed home? I stayed home today, okay? And then when somebody, God bless them, bought something from my eBay store, shout out to you, I put a mask on and went to the post office because that's what I'm supposed to do. So that's it. Just play by the rules. Stay home. And if you have to go out, put a mask on, okay? That's it. This ain't fucking hard. Don't make it difficult. Don't argue with people at the store about it. Don't be that person who's still walking around without a mask on in public. Please, just behave yourselves. I know. I don't like it. I got road rash on my face. But it is what it is. Until this shit blows over, this is what we gotta do. So another customer, we've got another employee. Their daughter is working there. She might be 15, 16 years old, if that. She's just helping out the store. So, I mean, she is a newbie. And when I say a newbie, like this is her first job ever. She is very quiet, sweet girl, nice. Close your ears, women. This, see you next Tuesday. This absolute cunt, went off on this little girl that works there. And she's outside cleaning the shopping carts. And this lady comes up and goes, excuse me. Excuse me. And the little girl's like, yeah. She goes, what do you mean I can't bring my reusable bags? I'm like, that's what the sign says. She's like, that is asinine. What about your germs from your shopping cart that's going to get on my food and get on my clothes and my purse and my Gucci belt and my blah, 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 just going off. And the girl was just standing there like, what on earth? And so she came inside because, of course, she got fucking scared. And the lady was like screaming in the store, this is asinine. So then I was like, yo, this lady's tripping, and if she doesn't settle down, Rambopra's gonna show up and toss this bitch right out. I'm not even gonna give her the spiel. I'm just gonna be like, leave your groceries here, get the fuck out, don't come back. Because I'm not gonna have you abusing some kid about a sign that she has no control over. She just works here. She didn't make the fucking policy. She didn't make the fucking sign. Chill the fuck out. So let her get her little shopping done, and I figured she would have calmed down. And just to give you a little backstory on this, see you next Tuesday, she's got five kids,
I want to say it's, yes, okay, 5 kids. One of them is a girl and the rest are boys. I get it. She's over fucking whelmed. But nobody asked her to have 5 kids. She didn't have to have 5 kids. She chose to have 5 kids. Of course, she has no control over them. They're all over the store, getting into shit, causing trouble. And miraculously, when their father is in the store, they all behave. But when they're with their mother, they are going off. Except for the daughter, because the daughter's like 16-ish. 14, 16. So she kind of knows better. So, but the rest of the kids, they're under 12. And they are little monsters. So she's always fussing, whining, and yelling, and doing all kinds of crazy stuff, okay? Now, I found it ironic that she would go off on a complete stranger, on somebody else's child that worked at the store. But she can't control her kids. She'll go off on somebody that works there, but she can't control her kids. Because normally they're doing bad stuff. She's just like, oh, stop. Please don't do that. Okay, cause, come on. All of a sudden, this lady has a set of bowls and starts yelling at my coworker like, what do you mean? You're going to get your germs all over my Gucci purse, all over my belt. I don't want your stuff. You're forcing me to not use my reusable bags. How asinine. Like, oh, no, 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 no. I tried to give her some time to cool down. I let her do get her shopping on. And, you know, I was still, my cat-like ears, I was still hearing yelling about the reusable bags. And my thought is, if you are going to be that upset about a store policy, guess what, bitch? You don't have to shop here. Okay? It's that fucking simple. You don't like the rules, you don't have to play by them. You just simply don't get to shop there. Leave your stuff in the basket and kick rocks. It's that easy. You don't have to be here. There's no gun to your head saying you gotta come here. Go to another store. Oh, but guess what? A lot of stores are doing this. They are not allowing reusable bags into the store to keep the germs away. So she keeps chirping, chirping, chirping around the store. And finally, my boss happens to just come down to take care of something. And I was like, hey, bro, you know, I don't normally tell you nothing or whatever. Like, I just keep working to mind my own business. But this lady right here is going off on other people that work here. And she keeps yelling. And she just keeps going on. And I'm telling you, bro, you might have a situation. I'm just letting you know. Okay? So he's like, all right, I'll hang out here up front. No big deal. I don't know if he realized the magnitude of cuntiness that was approaching. So, she comes to the line. She starts yelling again. And he's like, how you doing, ma'am? Did you find everything okay? So explain to me the asinine reason that I need to not use my reusable bags. What about my Gucci purse? What about my Gucci belt? What about my stuff that's gonna get germs all over it? And he said, well, ma'am, we have somebody outside who's cleaning the carts or wiping the carts down after every use. You know, we're doing the best that we can here. We have bags available for you that are brand new. You don't have to pay for bags. You can reuse these bags that we're giving you, okay? You can have these bags today. This is ridiculous. I can't believe that you guys would do this. This is not logical. What about... And he's like, ma'am, I'm trying to just explain to you that we're just trying to cut down on the germs coming back to us. We have to work here too. You shop here, we're trying to keep the most germ-free environment as possible. So if you're bringing stuff home, not saying it's you personally, but if stuff is coming in here, it could potentially affect some of our staff here. So we're just trying to keep it clean for the staff and for you. This is ridiculous. I am never shopping here again. So asinine. He's like, well, I'm sorry you feel that way, ma'am, but have a nice day. I was like, bye, bitch. Oh, my God. People are fucking dying. please. This is the best solution we could come up with. It's just giving you reusable bags that are brand new every fucking time. Until this is over. Once it's over, you can bring your nasty ass bags that you never washed back. And I'm telling you, as somebody who's bags people stuff, I'm telling you, I've seen dog shit in there. I've seen blood in there. I've seen God knows what in there. I've seen leaves in there. People don't clean that shit. People don't wash it. Some people do, but most people don't. So to save everybody from passing that shit around, we're just telling y'all to leave it at home. It is what it is. Don't like it, don't shop. Bye-bye. Shortly after that, a guy comes up, and of course our juice bar has been shut down, you know, just to keep stuff from being spread around, contamination, the whole nine yards, you know. And this guy comes up and goes, "Where's my juice?" And I was like, "Excuse me, sir?" "Yeah, where's my juice? I want my juice. I want my green drink." And I was like, "Oh, I'm sorry, sir. The juice bar is closed due to the virus. You know, we're trying to keep keep from spreading it as much as we can." "What virus?" And I was like, "Excuse me? What virus?" I was like, "Oh boy, here we go. Another conspiracy theory." I was like, "Oh, the coronavirus, sir. The reason you're wearing a mask."
"You mean the fake virus, the made up virus?"
And I was like, "Oh, I gotta go." I just walked away. I was like, "Oh,
the made up virus."
I was like, "Oh, well, we're located in Loma Linda. Just 25 minutes east of Loma Linda is Yucaipa, California. The place where they had 60 people in one nursing home get the coronavirus. You mind telling me if that's fake? You dumb son of a bitch? 60 people in one place. Sir, that's an outbreak, okay? They're not playing possum. They're fucking sick as hell. So, maybe whatever news station or Alex Jones you listen to, you better turn that off and turn on some real news, because they're lying to you, bruh. Straight up, there's a real virus and it's killing people. Thousands of people have died. Thousands more might die if they have the logic you have. The made-up virus. The make-believe virus. What virus? I want my green drink. Oh, God. You need more than a green drink. Holy shit. My God. Then finally I had a lady call. She's like, "I just want to know if you have some Zeke. We're sold out." "Well, did you check?"
"Declaration of war? Is this some white cunt's joke that black cunts don't get? Because I'm not fucking laughing, Nicholas."
Just listen to what the fuck I just said. "We don't have any zinc. If we had some, I'd fucking tell you. We don't have any. Goodbye."
"Well, did you check?"
"Oh, I'll do you one better, just to make you feel good, ma'am. We had one box this morning, because you didn't listen to Uncle Joey Diaz and get to the store right when it opens. You didn't fucking get it. Have a nice day." Click. Oh my God. Remember, Uncle Joey said get to the store early. If you listened to Uncle Joey, you would have had that box of zinc, bitch, but you didn't. And somebody bought it and it's gone. And now you gotta wait another 3 fucking weeks for some fucking zinc. And when I say 3 weeks, it's been 3 weeks and we got a case. We got 12 bottles and that was gone in 20 fucking minutes. So do yourself a favor. If you want something, get your ass to the fucking store early. Early bird gets the worm, bitch. Or in your case, you got the finger from me. Rambo, bro. Click. Oh, my God. I had an interesting discussion this week. I would like to think that doesn't happen, but it does. People talk about each other. It is what it is. That's part of life. Whether you're a good Christian or not, you talk shit on people. Hell, this is what my podcast is, shitting on people. Now, I always find it fascinating when people share stories about how they've had conversations with other people about me. This isn't bad, of course. I always find it fascinating how they interpret things that I say or I do or whatnot to other people, and other people's reaction is, I guess, other people's reaction is what I'm intrigued by. This week I had a conversation with a friend who had another conversation with a friend about transgender, transsexual, transvestite definitions. And I know that for some people, it's a tough thing to comprehend, to wrap their mind around, that their dear host, Rambover, their air quotes friend, is a part of that community. But I refuse to do nothing about it, because I just don't see the logic behind that. Now, for those people who are trans, who do listen to this show, please do not take that the wrong way. If you have transitioned or thinking about transition, please do what you need to do for your sake, for your situation. I feel like my situation, that the juice is not really worth the squeeze for me. It might be for you, but it isn't for me, that I feel. So yes, I do identify as trans, but I don't force people to use that. It's just Jen, because it's just that easy. You don't have to sit there and I'm not forcing you to use labels. I'm not saying that you should do this, that, and the other. Just know that it's just Jen, and I like vagina. The end. It's just Jen, and I just like vagina. The end. But not your vagina, okay? Now, listen here. Not your vagina. I have boundaries. And unless you're a hottie with the body, that is my time. Then all right. But please understand, if you are my friend, I'm not trying to bone you, because that's weird. So anyway, back to this conversation. And this friend was uncomfortable acknowledging this, that this even exists. And that's okay, too. But just understand that when you choose to not acknowledge someone's presence or existence, it's kind of fucking shitty, especially if you're their friend. I'm doing my best to respect this person's belief and their position, and I would ask that this person would respect my position as well. And I'm not saying that they have to use this. I'm not one of those kind of social justice warrior-y kind of people. Like, do whatever the fuck you want, as long as it's not hateful. If you were saying, you know, if you don't want to acknowledge my transness, then that's fine. You don't have to. I'm not going to tolerate you being hateful towards it, as far as like, you should fucking die, or you're a piece of shit, blah, 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 blah. Like, going down that road. This friend told me that friend, I would just say friend B, or friend A, told me that friend B said that, try not to laugh because it's fucking hilarious. okay, he said that transgender or transsexual is the same as transvestite. Oh my god. So I had a good laugh about it, and I just maybe want to educate y'all, those who are interested, on what these definitions are. So transgender or transsexual, they are the same, okay? Transgender is somebody who believes that they are born into the wrong gender, or they believe that they are another gender. Transsexual is in that realm, that lane, if you want to be particular about it. A transvestite is somebody who dresses up as this individual, but they do not believe that they are another sex, okay? So now that we've got that cleared up, so this friend does not look not smart saying that, because he is a smart person. It is comical if you say something like that to somebody. If my friend is really not careful, somebody might fight him over that. Because for some people, they are extremely passionate about that. So I'm trying to educate my friends or listeners who maybe don't understand what this is all about. And then the conversation proceeded to go into a place where friend B feels like they're being attacked, or they're being attacked if they don't use those words. Like they're being forced, like society is forcing them to say this. And since I've known friend B for I'm terrible at math, which is why I'm not a doctor. So since from 99, 2000, even before this information all came out, this friend B was always apprehensive. I'm not sure if it's some things that I say or do. Maybe it is both, or the way I dress. Something about me makes friend B apprehensive about me. So we've known each other for some time, but we're not close, air quotes. And I think this stems from where I'm going now, is that friend B feels threatened by society that they are forced to say transgender or acknowledge other minorities. because friend B feels like a minority, even though he is not. Oh boy. I'm laughing because this might ruffle some feathers, but that is fine. This is why I have this show, because I gotta say some shit before I jump to the other side, before I move on to the other side. And I could not go to my grave without letting friend B know, or many others listeners know who are like friend B, who are worried about their air quote privilege, if you will, if it's being threatened or not. And I just simply say that that is not true. Maybe friend B watches a little too much TV. And I think friend B should maybe listen, open their mind to maybe some podcasts. And I'm not saying that podcasts are right. Maybe friend B should listen to my podcast. Because I know they don't. I feel like maybe friend B is stuck in their own echo chamber. And it's just getting a lot of yes things to their ideas and their ideology. And I feel that that is very sad, and that friend B should maybe venture out and listen to different things, even if they don't agree with what those things are. At least get something from a different perspective. Friend B has never sat me down and said, "This is how I feel." Friend B has said it behind my back. And that's perfectly fine, because I understand that friend B is very scared, because his ideology could potentially be questioned. He could be wrong. And unfortunately with friend B, he doesn't like to be wrong a lot. So, or at least proven wrong. So I found this clip from the Aubrey Marcus podcast, which I will be playing some other bits later. But I thought it was really cool that I had that conversation with friend A about friend B. And it came to the ideology thing, and I was searching for the right thing to say to my friend, but I couldn't. And I hadn't listened to the podcast until after I got done talking to my friend. And I'll probably text this to him. But I want y'all to hear this, and I think it's really cool.
That's why people have such a hard time changing their minds, is because, and this is in the book, maybe this is what you're referring to, but it's the differences between ideas and ideologies, because ideas are tools that you can use that will change as your truth and your experience changes, whereas ideologies become a part of your identity. And so to change your mind means a part of you has to die. Mm. And that's why people hold on so tightly to their ideologies. They just they refuse to make any changes that represent who they are. And in that way, you know, they can't move with the flow of life.
Crazy, right? I think friend B, we aren't close. Because I think in a roundabout way, he's intimidated with the idea that for the most part, I'm able to get ideas and change with those ideas. I'm not so steadfast in my ideologies. I change with it pretty, for certain things, I change pretty easy. Obviously, there are other things that I might be a little bit more steadfast in, but in time, I've changed from that, or in time, I could change from that. And I think with friend B, not to bash friend B, but I just think he's not ready or is unwilling to change his ideology or open his mind to that because he's afraid that he could be wrong. And that sucks. And that's the reason why I really don't associate too much with friend B. And I'm sure that's the reason why friend B doesn't associate with me, because something about that bothers him. I catch that vibe when I do associate with him, that there is that factor there, because to him, I'm a wild card, which to my wild friends, I'm nowhere close to being wild. But to him, I'm a wild card. And so because I am unpredictable of what I might say or do, or that I'm free and confident in myself as far as that I do date women. Maybe it's been a long time, but I do. that I'm secure with that, or the fact that I don't know. I can't really pinpoint something, but maybe it's something of a part of my masculinity that might bother him. I'm not sure. But I've had this for a long time. As long as I've known him, there has always been that handout. Don't go to the next level with me. Don't go any deeper than this, because I'm not prepared to go there. And that's perfectly fine. Everybody has their limits. Obviously, I'm an open book, because that's why I have the show, is because I'm trying to be an open book, because I can't learn. I understand that I can't learn anything if I'm a closed book. And unfortunately for friend B, a lot of his life is a closed book. And as an outside observer, that makes me sad, because he still draws breath from his lungs. He has the ability to make the change, but doesn't see the necessity in it. So anyway, for those of you who are the homies who do see me every day or talk to me, obviously right now we're in quarantine, or text or whatever's going on, FaceTime and the works, whatever, I don't expect you to be like, oh, so you're trans, or oh, so you're gay. I don't expect you to be hard on the labels, because that's not really the importance of our friendship, or that's really not the importance of you listening. The importance of our friendship or you listening is that you have an understanding, is that we understand each other, and that we can compromise with one another, that you have an understanding that yes, I am a part of the homosexual community, yes, I'm a gay lady, yes, I am trans or whatever, but my intent is to not cause harm, okay? My intention is to have fun and find the woman of my dreams and laugh and do crazy stuff. My intentions are not going out to hurt people. My intention is not to be like, if you don't say this, then you should be arrested. I'm not one of those people. In Canada, if you don't use the right pronouns, you could be arrested. That's some fucked up shit. I don't agree with that at all. That's where my brother Jordan Peterson comes in and says, that is not cool. I'll leave the option up to you. Whatever you're comfortable with. The easiest one for me, what my comfort level is just Jen. Don't complicate it. Don't make it harder than what it is. Just Jen. Okay? It's so easy. This week, I had some friends in a group chat ask me if I were to have gone through with my transition, what was my name going to be? Because they found it funny that a lot of people who do transition spell their name backwards, which I find hilarious. So he was like, it's going to be Ninja. I was like, well, it already is Ninja, motherfucker. It's Beverly Hills Ninja to you, bitch. James, and we'll get to you in a fucking minute, bro. Side note, can you fucking believe this real quick? My homie James has never heard of Earth, Wind, and Fire. What the fuck? Hold on. Give me your black card right now, James. Right fucking now. You don't. We'll get through it in a fucking minute. I'm telling you, this is some shit, but that's why we're playing Earth, Wind, and Fire today. My man James, even though he is a gay man, he's not your typical gay man, but he does not know Earth, Wind, and Fire. That is disturbing on all levels, okay? But we'll get to that in a minute. So he and a couple of my homies were like, yo, are you gonna spell your name backwards? And I was like, no, I'm actually gonna take the name that I was supposed to have because my parents didn't know if I was gonna be a boy or a girl, or maybe they just fucking did and they didn't want to tell me that. But if I was a boy, they were going to name me James. So that was the name that was picked out. So, I was like, yeah, it's going to be James. And then I said, besides, some family members who are under the age of 7, some of my cute little cousins, when they were really, really young, and even some of them now, they call me Jimmy anyway, because they couldn't say Jennifer, so they just said Jimmy Fur. So they just call me Jimmy. So I was like, yo, it's just Jimmy or James or whatever the fuck, like, who cares? But I'm not getting technical with all this shit, just thoughts, just throwing them against the wall. It just so happens to be my life, and you know, that's it. I follow somebody on Instagram who almost transitioned. She went through the whole 9, and right when she's about to have surgery, she changed her fucking mind. So shit happens. She's happier with a more masculine, she has more of a masculine appearance, sort of, but she still has very feminine quality face thing going on. So she's glad. She says she's glad she didn't go through with it. So not everybody can go through with this. Not saying that I can't. I just, like I said, I just don't think the juice is worth the squeeze. It is what it is. So I want to talk to you guys about my homie James. Who does not? First, we got on discussion. I was just like, man, that's why the 70s were cool. The music, or that's why the 70s and 80s were so cool. The music was amazing. And he goes, no, it wasn't. And I was like, the fuck, bitch? Yes, it was. And he's like, no, like, I like Pink Floyd. And he's like, name me some good rock or 70s great music or whatever, and we'll see. And I was just like, okay, do you have all day? Because I can do this all day. So I was like, Led Zeppelin. I was like, Pink Floyd. He was like, I like Pink Floyd. Led Zeppelin's overrated. And I was just like, you son of a bitch. I used to play Led Zeppelin on drums for 6 hours a day. My dad would beg me to get off the drums because all I would play was Led Zeppelin. Are you joking, man? John Bonham is one of the greatest drummers of all fucking time. Jimmy Page. Robert Plant. Do you remember Laughter? Do
Someone told me there's a girl out there with love in her eyes and flowers in her hand.
Same kind of punch, kind of bark, it's getting bold, it's getting squirrely, they bark, it's a loop, it's a bit, it's damn down. Better than them and me, but down. Better than love and deal and swell.
Fuck, man. Going to California is like my favorite fucking Led Zeppelin song. Oh, my God. And then, of course, all the drum solos on there. He's like, yeah, they're overrated. I was like, oh, fuck. And I was like, what about Pink Floyd? And I was like,
the lunatic is on the grass. Shine on your crazy diamond.
He's like, I like Pink Floyd, but I was like, oh yeah, what about? I was like, what about the sweet
fox on the run? And they made me go.
He's like, just shout him out. I was like, bro, the 70s were sick, man. I was like, what about Joni Mitchell?
Help me. I was like, I'm falling, falling in love.
I was like, Stevie? What about fucking Stevie? Come on, man.
Oh, it's just a make you cry. Make it that now. Get it on in today, but now. Get it need it all, but now.
And I was like, fucking heart. Barracuda. And he's like, man. I was like, okay. Well, of course you would agree with Earth, Wind, and Fire. I mean, come on. Earth, Wind, and Fire bridges the gaps between blacks and white people. Like, Earth, Wind, and Fire is like universal. And he's like, what? Never heard of it. I was like,
ah! You!
No, no friend of mine has not heard of Earth, Wind, and Fire, you son of a bitch. I was like, say that again, god damn it. He's like, yeah, I don't think I've heard of Earth, Wind, and Fire before. I was like, oh, I said, this bitch is a witch. James, you are a witch. Oh my god, you will be burnt at the stake at once. I said, how do you not know the greatest band of all time that everybody loves? I have never, ever, ever heard anyone say a bad thing about Earth, Wind, and Fire. It is the fucking shit. Let's groove tonight. Come on, man. He's like, no, never heard of it. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, okay, what about? You're a shining star, no matter who you are. But I'm about to see.
Shining star for you to see what your life can truly be. Shining star for you to see what your life can truly be.
Man, I was like, ugh. And I was like, okay, okay, okay. Maybe this one. I was like, oh my god. I was like, bro, you were just trying to tell me that I should sleep with you 2-3 weeks ago. I can't. I mean, you're a man. I don't like men, but I was like, bro, if the world ends, like, and you're the last friend I gotta sleep with. I ain't sleeping with you, fam. I'm not sleeping with you. You don't know who Earth, Wind, and Fire is. And the word that I pray for you, you don't even fucking like. Oh my god. Drown this witch at once.
Bam 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 federal. I'm like, bruh, how do you not know this shit? Oh my god, this is terrible. And I was like, come on, I mean, who doesn't want to sing Earth, Wind, and Fire? This man is sick. Anybody sees James on the street, he's a trucker. I want you to give him the fucking finger. I demand the wrath of our nation and the legion of truckers. Find James on the road. Put it out on the CB radio. Attention, truckers. We got a 10-4. We got ourselves a convoy rubber ducky. He doesn't know where Earth, Wind, and Fire is. We got a big old convoy running through the night. We got a convoy here, and James isn't invited. 10-4. That's right. He don't know who Earth, Wind, and Fire is. What? Come on, man. Earth, Wind, and Fire is the fucking best, man. The best band. This is Universal. I want you to find me somebody who does not like Earth, Wind, and Fire. Find them for me, and you tell them. You tell them, and you tell them to get in touch with Rambover, because I will punch them in the fucking face. You do say hi, we did it, but it did. Why, baby, did it? Did it? Did it? Did it? Did Man, I've never met a freaking person in my life that does not like Earth, Wind, and Fire. So I was beside myself. Actually, a lot of us were in the group chat. They were like, whoa, 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 Earth, Wind, and Fire. Come on, man. Come on. You're joking, right? He's like, no, no. I mean, some of these ones you're playing, they're okay, but nah, I don't never heard of them. I probably wouldn't listen. I'm like, what? Oh, man. James! Damn you! God damn you, man. All right. Well, let's see. Now it's time to talk about some dating shit. And I just, I've reached a breaking point. I think this is it. Last call. I have reached a breaking point with all these apps. I have decided now, unless I get an alert, I am no longer sending messages out to people. I am no longer making the first move. I am done with this shit, which means I will probably never get somebody to send me anything, and that's fine. I have accepted this now, because it's just too much work, too much time, too much energy. It's wasted. It's gone. I can't get it back. And I would just rather devote that time to something else that is a little bit more healthier to my soul. And I heard this clip from Aubrey Marcus podcast again, and he was talking about vibrations and the vibration you put out there. And I'm like, man, if I'm putting this vibration out there, like, I have to meet somebody. I have to get this over with. I gotta get off these dating apps, because I have to get off these fucking dating apps, because they drive me fucking crazy. That's why I'm so aggressive with this shit. It's because I gotta get off this shit. I can't fucking stand it. I hate it. And when I heard this, I was like, oh shit. Fuck. Son of a bitch is right. Let me get this for you.
Yeah, because your superpower is your kryptonite, right? And so I think understanding that then allows you maybe to choose not to victimize yourself or blame other people. And then by doing that, you just perpetuate the same story. Mm-hmm. And then that's what you're attracted to unconsciously, and it's what you continue to attract. You know, I mean, we're all just vibrating energy. So if you change your frequency, you change what you're attracted to and what you attract. Mm-hmm.
But I think it's a complicated process, and to find forgiveness and gratitude not at the expense of the grieving that I know both of us have gone through, which is those negative emotions, you know, not suppressing those and pretending like they don't exist or finding ways to distract from them, because then, of course, they just become something else.
I am identifying these emotions, and those emotions are a sense of fucking panic. And this panic has stemmed from just the simple fact of how bad the relationship was, and I'm in desperate need to erase it from the scorecard. You understand? It was just so fucking bad. Also, this panic is in a roundabout way to let people know, like, hey, I'm fucking over this. I'm over this. Don't think I'm not with somebody because I don't want to be with somebody because of that last biatch.
Biatch! No way. Biatch! No way.
It's so goddamn hard to find somebody good, and I think it's taking so long for me because my criteria has changed completely. It is back to originally what I've wanted, and if you don't meet that criteria, you're arrivederci, bon voyage. I don't want you around me, so I'm not going to sort change myself, and that is how I got in the mess that I got into last time, you understand? So I don't want no mess, I don't want no drama, I don't want no fucking games, and so I figure by the time somebody meets my criteria, I'll probably be dead, but if I'm still alive, this is what I want. So that is why I am single, because there have been people who just do not meet my criteria. That is just plain and simple. I don't know what more else I can say. That is the reason. It has nothing to do with the weirdo. But I don't want it to be perceived as that. And it seems like that's what's going on. And I just want to let the public know I am fucking trying, goddammit. I am trying to the point of where it has now become detrimental to my well-being that I stop trying now. That is it. That is, I'm pulling the plug. I'll still have dating apps. I'm not going to be constantly checking them day and night. I asked a friend for some advice on this one time, and she suggested that I join another dating app. Hey, thanks. No. I did join another dating app, and that just added more ish to my plate. Now, there were more women who met the criteria, but in a roundabout way, they didn't, because they simply just did not want to put an effort into trying. Like, the match process went through. We sent the message. I sent a message, or they sent a message, but then nothing comes out of it. So I'll just have to say that it is me. I'm terrible at this. I'm terrible at dating. And that's it. I'm taking the L, and I'm going to walk away now. I'm walking away. Thank you, Craig David. I just have to walk away from my sanity because I'm feeling it's time now. It's been a long time. It's been a whole lot of nothing other than grief. And like I said, I'll still keep them, but I'm not going out of my way to do anything about it. If somebody happens to message me on there, I'll respond, but I'm not throwing myself out there to be messaging everybody, all these ladies first. This is just it's just annoying. What is now happening is I'm actually getting inundated with women who just want to have conversations for the sake of having conversations. They don't actually want to have a relationship. They just want to talk because they're bored. And I already have friends. So thank you. I appreciate it. Good night. Good night. God bless. I'm just not having it. I'm just like, man, what the fuck is this? So like, okay, we're talking, but okay, so where is this gonna go? Like, are we planning on meeting up? What's the deal? No, there's no intention. So the second that starts to come into the equation, immediately they disappear. So that tells me your intentions, and thank you for doing that early, so I don't have to waste 7 years of my fucking life trying to figure out what the fuck your intentions are, because I'm not doing that again. You better come ready and fully prepared. Not expecting you to be fully healed, because I am fucking fully healed. Nobody is fucking perfect. nor will they be, or nor will they ever be. But I've just reached a state in my life, and I'm not trying to be elitist, but or snobby or nasty. I just want somebody who knows what the fuck they want and is secure within themselves knowing what they want. They don't have to have everything fucking figured out, but at least have some sense of direction or purpose. With most things, I cannot do the I am healed, so let me heal you thing. Because that doesn't work, because then that just takes powers away from me. And then if I try to give them to the other person, that is not enough, and it will never be enough. So I'm slowly starting to figure this out. Okay, Erica? Okay, are you listening? I'm figuring this out, baby steps. But I feel good about it. That's the most important thing, is I feel good about it and the direction that I'm heading. And it is less dating app time. Okay? All y'all ladies who are a part of the gay persuasion and who do choose to message me, I appreciate you. Go on ahead and slide in the DMs. Send nudes, not dudes. But just know that your sense of purpose is to have a relationship and some sort of partnership. This isn't like some weird, like, use me, use you kind of thing. Like, I'm not well. That is not well for my soul. I am looking for something who adds to my life and is not subtracting to it. Catch that dirt. Oh, that felt good. All right. I think I must turn this off. I must go on about my life. I've fucked this show up enough. I have things to do, like go and sit in the corner and maybe have a cry. I don't know. We'll see what the day brings. That's isolation for you. The good news is I've been jumping rope. My leg doesn't hurt so bad, which means I am going to move around and probably use the punching bag. So I'm going to get warmed up with the jump rope. And I am going to try and do my best to process this thing I call my life, me Vita Loca. I appreciate you for listening. Tell a friend, but only if they're cool. Ramble Burrito, RambleBurrito.com. Don't bother to go to RambleBurrito.com. I haven't updated that shit in ages, unless you want to click on the link to find more cool shows, or maybe you think they're shit and listen to more shit shows. Either way, it doesn't matter. It's out there. I do this once again for the one person, that one individual. Maybe it is you. Maybe it is someone else you know. But I do this for the one person. Actually, two people. One of them is me, of course. And the second person is that one individual who will enjoy this message in a bottle long after I'm gone. I thank you. Much love. I thank you for listening. I thank you for your support. All 11 of you who may not care to listen once I am gone. Please like, share, and subscribe to Ramble Up Radio. And once again, tell a friend, but only if they're cool. No negative Nancys, no sensitive Sallys. Truth slayers and lie slayers. I hope I slayed a lot of lies this episode. And of course, once again, a lot of my friends who don't listen to the show are probably sensitive Sallys. Shit, I'm on fire. Catch that dirt. Or they just don't they don't have time. I'll take that. They don't have time. That will be well with my soul. They don't have the time to listen to my show, and that's perfectly all right. I don't expect them to listen to my show if they are my friend, but it would be nice if they call me a friend and they would listen to my show and tell me they love it or tell me they hate it. That's fine. It's all criticism that I can take. And that I appreciate. Here's what you can do. This is what you shouldn't do. And then I will go from there and decide if I should or I shouldn't. I probably won't. But this is my message in a bottle to my dear friends after I've dearly departed this earth. But in the meantime, I will continue to make episodes because I love you. Te amo. Unless you have a penis, no homo. Damn it. All right. So hard to say goodbye. Shit. This isolation is really getting to me. I guess the only way I can say goodbye is because my leg hurts sitting in this chair this long, so I have to get up and move around, and I can't podcast and move around. It's just kind of weird. So, until then...
No! No! Nigga, show! Nigga, show! No!
So... This is the footage of a young man who is in a police standoff with the police and refuses to leave his home. He refuses to leave his home, and he's proclaiming that they shoot him with a taser gun as he opens the door. And as he does open the door, he does get shot. So here we go. Oh, this is great. You fucking kid. My man's is just going off. Oh my god. Oh my god. Let's see, I'm trying to think if there's anything else that's important. I think that might be it. Unless you want to listen to some of my mixes. Let me see what I got here. You get the picture. I'm getting pretty decent with my mixing during this social isolation time. I mean, I am going to work, working my ass off. But when my leg doesn't hurt too much, because, you know, when I mix, I got to stand. You know, when you DJ, you got to stand. And so I did see Calvin Harris was doing a live stream. He was sitting down. Son of a bitch, you're cheating. But I'm going to try and sit down and see, because I'd like to practice more. I'd like to get good mixing. That one, that mix I did, I believe I was, I was sitting down. So it seems like my mixing is a little bit better if I sit down and think about it. So anyway, that's me mixing. I tried to go live on IG and of course they shut my shit down. I did see that some people are posting as they're mixing that they do not own the music. So maybe I need to put a big fat sign so Instagram can stop. Get off my jock about copyright shit. Okay, so one more clip. I got this doctor guy here saying that you don't need the fucking gloves.
Explain why you don't need to wear gloves when you go out. You got your gloves, you're at the supermarket, you're touching things. There you go, germs. You keep touching more things throughout the day with these same gloves. Germs everywhere. You're accumulating germs. Your glove is now more full of germs than your hand would have been if you washed each time. And remember, with these same gloves, you'll be touching your steering wheel. You might accidentally touch your hand, transferring the germs to yourself. And then when you're changing your gloves, you might be actually touching the glove itself. Just wash your hands, be sensible, stay safe.
Thank you, Dr. Karen Raj. Raj? Karen, surgeon, telling you you don't need your fucking gloves, you dumb son of a bitch. Just wear your fucking mask. Everything will be all right. All right? That's it. I appreciate every single one of you motherfuckers who listen. All 11 of you. Tell a friend, but make sure they're not sensitive, because this ain't the show if you're sensitive or whatever. We have a cry every now and then. We get the gay rage. We smash things. We smash eggy whites. We love. But at the end of it all, we love. We love. Thank you so much. I appreciate every single one of you. This is Rambo Burrito, and I'm out. Peace.